guys, this is what we're doing. I'm AnimeIntensity, and welcome back to my channel. Fall 2017 anime are right around the corner. Even though it feels like it's still 80 degrees outside, so it doesn't feel like fall yet. It still feels like summer, but fall 2017 anime are about to start, I think, like next week or something. So it's pretty sudden, you know? The summer 2017 anime season just finished off. So now we're moving along, transitioning to the next season, and that's always a bunch of fun. And I was like, hey, I haven't made a video on it yet. Let's talk about fall 2017 anime. Yeah. This video, I'm gonna be talking about my top 10 most anticipated anime for the season. I can't go through the whole chart. The chart is huge like usual, so I'm only gonna be talking about my top 10 most anticipated series for this season. A lot of series this season are actually sequels, so this actually reminds me of like another season from another year where it was really sequel heavy. This is another season. Fall 2017 is a sequel heavy season from what I've seen so far, so I expect to see a lot of familiar faces and characters and cool stuff, so that should be a lot of fun. But yeah, my top 10 anime that I'm anticipating for fall 2017, let's get started. And as usual, feel free to comment below with your top 10 or which anime you're really looking forward to for the anime season.
So let's start off with number 10. All Summer Game, the animation. So I actually read the prequel manga or something like that, and it was pretty interesting. I read it really quickly because it was really engaging and interesting, but this is like a horror, supernatural mystery kind of anime set in a school, and there's 32 students who receive a text message on their cell phones which tell them that they're playing the Osama game and they have to, you know, fulfill these tasks in a 24-hour period. And basically, you know, people don't believe it, and if they don't do it, basically they die. So it's like they need to figure out what exactly is the Osama game and stuff like that. I really love stories like this, so I definitely want to check out the anime. I don't know how it will be because horror anime is kind of like a hit or miss in a lot of situations, but I definitely want to check it out anyway because I really loved that prequel that we have on Crunchyroll manga. So hopefully it turns out interesting, but yeah, I think it's pretty cool. I'm waiting for it. Number 9. Yes, Irae. I don't know. This one looks really interesting. I mean, I wasn't too impressed by the PV, but I do like action. I do like superpowers, and I do like that, you know, somebody's life is turned upside down because now people are attacking each other and there's beheadings and, you know, different things going on, and he loses his best friend because they fought and they stopped being friends, and, you know, battles and magic and cool stuff. And so I'm going to give this one a try. I don't know too much about it, but it looks interesting. We'll see how that goes. Number 8. Junie Tyson. This anime looks really, really interesting. I love the PV. I think it looks like something that I definitely want to check out, so I hope it lives up to that momentum. But it's basically like Zodiac warriors, basically. Not Knights of the Zodiac exactly, but you know basically every 12 years these warriors that have the names of the zodiac signs fight to the death. It's a battle royale, and I like stuff like that, so I think it should have a lot of action, a lot of excitement. I think the PV looks pretty interesting, and I can't wait to watch it because it looks like something that I'll really enjoy, and I've seen a lot of hype around it. So I will definitely be checking out Junie Tyson. Looks pretty cool. I like stuff like that. Number 7. Inuyashiki. So Inuyashiki is actually a manga that I read on Crunchyroll manga, and I loved it so much, so I really cannot wait for the anime. See, it getting an anime is very, very exciting. It's going to be 11 episodes by MAPPA, so that should be really interesting. It's about this guy, this old guy, who has about like 3 months to live, and his family doesn't care about him, only the dog likes him, and so he ends up getting killed by aliens because they like they landed incorrectly, and so they rebuilt him. He turned into a robot, and you just have to definitely check this out. Number 6. Osomatsu-san season 2. I absolutely loved the first season of Osomatsu, so I really couldn't wait for a season 2. This was probably like one of the most popular anime series in Japan last year. It was everywhere. So I am not surprised that it's getting a season 2, but I am so glad that it's getting a season 2. It's so funny, and I love all 6 of the brothers, the Matsuno brothers. So naturally, I am going to be watching Osomatsu-san. I think it's hilarious. I love Totti, and I just love all of them, but Totti is my favorite. And yeah, so it's going to be really hilarious, and I can't wait to see more of the silliness that we see in Osomatsu-san.
Number 5.
Konohana Kitan. It's a yokai anime, so it's kind of like a slice of life slash yokai anime, because we have fox spirits who are working in a hot spring inn, and we have a new employee, Yuzu, and she's learning how to adjust to this new life. It's sweet. She doesn't know what to expect and things like that. So I'm really, really excited for Konohana Kitan. I love little cute yokai. So I'm definitely going to give this one a try.
Number 4.
Blend S. So this is actually like a comedy slash slice of life. It's based on a 4-koma manga. And it's by A1 Pictures, which I trust with my life because I love A1 Pictures. They've released so many things that I absolutely love. But it really takes place in a cafeteria, and the waitresses have to act according to their attributes, which is very interesting. The trailer looks funny and really, really cute. I love the designs and everything, so I definitely have to give this a try because I love cute things like this, especially when it takes place in a cute little cafe with cute little food and everything. I love that kind of stuff, so I'll definitely be checking that out. And plus, I need something to laugh at. So, you know, I love comedy, so very excited.
Number 3.
Code Realize. Sose no Hime Gimi. So, I actually have Code Realize. It's an amazing otome game. It's really, really great. And if you haven't played it already, please do. It's so good. But, yeah, so this anime is something that I actually didn't expect. I didn't expect a Code Realize anime so soon, especially since we just got it localized maybe like 2 years ago. But I'm still really hyped for it. I mean, there's a lot of cute guys, and we're in London, and, you know, Cardia, she's isolated from the world, and she has a deadly poison and she carries a deadly poison on her body, so anything that she touches ends up rotting or melting, and she's like a monster, and she never thought she would fall in love, and there's a bunch of handsome men. Okay, just, I'm really excited. If it's anything like the visual novel, it is going to be packed with emotion and love, and oh, it's going to be so good if it's just as good as the visual novel. So I'm hyped. I think it's going to be cool, and I can't wait.
Number 2.
Hoseki no Kuni. I don't really know too much about this anime, like, at all, but I know that it's about, like, these gems that have to fight against these moon people who want to attack them and turn them into decorations. So each gem has, like, a specific role when they go try to fight against the moon people, and, you know, I don't... it's kind of strange when you read the plot like that, but I think it looks really interesting, and I want to give it a try, even though I haven't heard too much about it. But it looks kind of cool. Like, what can I say? And I like gems, and I, you know, battles and things like that. So we'll see how that goes, but I'll probably give it a couple of episodes.
And last but not least, number 1.
The Ancient Magus's Bride. I don't know if you guys knew this, but I absolutely love the Ancient Magus's Bride manga and the OVAs. So naturally, of course, I'm saving this one for last because I'm really, really excited for this. I think this is definitely going to be an excellent, excellent anime. But it is beautiful. It is gorgeous. And those are both the same thing. But still, it is a really awesome, like, fantasy manga. It's being made by WIT Studio, or WIT, I don't know, WIT Studio, which also worked on Attack on Titan, Kamen Rider of the Iron Fortress, and, you know, we see Hattori Chise, and she's had a really depressing life, but basically she meets this really interesting man that has a head of a beast and has a lot of strange powers, and just watch it, please. It's so good. It's so good. So, please go watch it.
So, yeah, I think those were it. Those were my top 10 most anticipated anime for the fall 2017 anime season. I'm sorry if I couldn't talk about everything that's going to be airing during the season. And I'm pretty sure there's something that I'm missing that I'm like, oh, I'm going to really enjoy that. And then I totally forgot to mention it. I'm pretty sure that always happens. But anyway, feel free to comment below with what you're anticipating for fall 2017. Always like hearing your comments from all of you. You all are so awesome. Anyway, thank you guys for watching this video. Totally appreciate it. Feel free to like, share, or subscribe if you enjoy this video, and I'll see you guys next time.